live at the Utah Assistive Technology Program. As you can see, I'm not alone here today. I brought up two great people who have been involved in the project, as we have right here in front of us. I have Shaun Dahle from Intermountain Healthcare. He's a physical therapist up there. And I have Mike Stokes, who is a retired volunteer and has been on many adventures here at the shop, has done a lot of work and was very involved in this one. I'm going to turn a little bit of time over to Shaun. He's kind of the brainchild, I guess you can say, of this creation, and came up with the idea of how this could help in his practice. So go ahead, Shaun.
Great, thank you. We have worked with the AT Lab for many years, providing projects mainly to fill needs that aren't readily filled by typical equipment that we can obtain for kids, custom-built things, things of that nature. So after working with them for a long time and seeing the capabilities that they have and the things that they can do, I just began trying to figure out ways to innovate and fix problems that we're seeing in our clinic. And one of the big problems that we see often is that we don't have the ability to send activities home with families. And as therapy services get reduced by insurance companies to fewer and fewer visits a year, we need to find ways to actively engage the children that we work with so that they're able to do these things at home. And one of the top things that we have in our clinic are these adaptive tricycles. And they're motivating, and there's a lot of things about them that allow kids to work in ways that they otherwise couldn't. And so we use them a lot, but as we tried to send those activities home with parents, it is almost impossible for these children, or many of them, to ride a bike that's not adapted or a tricycle that's not adapted. And we'll get into some of the reasons why that is in just a few minutes. But we tried to find some way of adapting trikes, is how we kind of started this project. And then, and as I started working with Mike more and more, and we've done a few, you know, smaller projects, single projects, we thought of trying to come up with something bigger that would help, that could help a wider variety of people, instead of trying to find individual trikes and adapt them one at a time and running into a host of problems that are particular to that bike. We had to come up with something more global that would work across a wider variety of kids. So I'll just kind of let Mike go into, from his perspective, how this particular this particular project came about.
Thanks, Shaun. Again, the main goal was to come up with something at a lower cost to the end client, to the children, and for the parents, so that they could afford a product that they could use. And also, in the design of this, the goal was to build it out of a PVC. The purpose of that was to make it so that anybody anywhere in the world could technically take the plans that we've developed and get online, order the parts, and assemble it wherever they are. And so that was part of the process over the last year. That was probably one of the hardest things to do, is every time we worked on it and tried to adapt something, it required thinking back in the box, so to speak, to keep it within those parameters that anybody could build this with the parts that were available over the internet. Because it would have been very simple to put this thing together probably in 30 days and just made it happen. But keeping in mind that we had to keep it focused on the point of being able to be built anywhere. Some of the things that we put into this, obviously, the material is a furniture-grade PVC, which means that the testing that these folks have done on this is that they can take like a 100-pound drop weight and put the piece underneath it and hit it, and it just bends. It just flexes. Where if you take a normal PVC fitting like your sprinkler pipe, it's obviously going to shatter. And so this is UV protected. The other beautiful thing about it is it comes in about six different colors, and it's not just painted, but it's actually poured in the colors that anybody would. The other features on it is we added a front handle so that the PT or parent can pull the child, as well as the rear handle to be able to push. And so there's response happening and interaction as you're working with the children. The other thing, obviously, is the strapping mechanisms. And Shaun can go through some of these things from the standpoint of medical, more terminology. But the other area was we tried to keep it at a very low cost, because typically this specific trike, if you were to buy it retail, would run anywhere from $1,200 to $1,600. This will be coming in under $400, closer probably to $300, $350. And so, and again, anybody could take and put the parts together. It's just a matter of cutting the pipe to the correct lengths and gluing it and assembling it. So, Shaun?
Okay, so I will go into just a little bit of what makes an adaptive tricycle different than a normal tricycle or a bicycle. So first, the first thing being is that with a normal bicycle, you have a coaster system. So I don't know if, can you see this, the tricycle? When you move the tricycle, the wheels automatically move with it. So what this allows is once the child has momentum, the tricycle actually uses that momentum to bring their other foot forward. Or many kids, when they're first learning with their feet, they cannot advance one foot without accidentally putting on the brake. And so that was a key feature. The other feature is the gearing. The gearing needs to be low. It prevents the child from going too fast, and it also makes it easier for them to move the tricycle. A higher gear lets you go to higher speed, but lots of kids do not have the ability to generate the force necessary with their feet. And so we tried several different gearings, and they were able to custom cut until we found just the right amount for what we wanted in general. But this can be adapted to each individual child just by cutting out a specific sprocket for that. Then the other parts are just having a seat that can be supportive. A lot of children that use this won't have the trunk control to safely sit on a seat. So we have straps, and we can strap them in, and we can even do more than this. We can do laterals and things of that nature as well. Other key features for this tricycle is just the fact that the seat goes up and down, so the seat can be raised and lowered and just give us more growth for the child. And there's other features as well, but I think those are the key features that make the tricycle work for the population.
Perfect. Thank you, guys. And just a reminder to everyone out there, this totally exists in industry, meaning you can buy an adaptive trike. There are companies that sell them. This is one, though, that comes in significantly lower, like Mike was talking about, cost-wise. And it's also one that anybody can make. This is something that you can make in your backyard, so to speak. We are going to be taking the designs and plans for this and posting them onto the internet, probably onto our website. You can download them from there. Or you can come and talk to us directly. We'd be happy to make it for you. And we just do it at cost of material. So we're not making any money on making it. We're just trying to provide it for the community. Our website is uatpat.org. And I'm Daniel Crowley, and as always, feel free to give me a call at 435-797-0699. Thanks for joining us today.